Hey, welcome to Draft Academy. My name is Mike. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how to use classes and objects in C#. Now, classes and objects is actually a big subject, and there's a lot for me to talk about in this particular topic. But this video is just going to be a very basic introduction into what classes and objects are and how we can start using them in our C# programs. Now, in C#, we're going to be dealing with all types of data. And a lot of times when you're writing your programs, you're going to want to work with and represent different things in your programs. And by default, C# gives us a bunch of different data types that we can work with. So in C#, we can represent things like text. So we can use strings to represent text. We can represent characters. We can represent whole numbers with integers. And we can represent decimal numbers with things like doubles and floats, right? We can also represent true and false values with Boolean variables. But here's the problem is with just those limited data types, we're not going to be able to represent or model everything that we'd want in our programs. In other words, there's a lot of things in the real world that can't just be represented using a string or a number or a Boolean, right? I mean, think of something like a phone, for example. Like imagine I wanted to represent a phone inside of my program. Well, I can't represent a phone with like a string. You know, I can't represent a phone with just a number. Like a phone is a complex entity in the real world. And I can't sort of break it down into just one single like string or number, right? I can't represent it using just one of those data types. And that's kind of one of the limitations that you're gonna encounter is like, you can't represent everything just using one of these data types. So what I wanna talk to you guys about today is something called classes and objects. And classes and objects essentially allow you to create your own custom data types. By default, we're given things like strings, numbers, and Booleans, but I could actually create my own data type that would allow me to represent something that I wanted inside of my program. So generally what we'll do when we want to create a data type in C# is we'll create something called a class. And a class is basically just a specification for a new data type. So I could create a class for a phone, or I could create a class for like a water bottle, or I could create a class for a keyboard or a computer. And then I could represent all those different things inside my programs. So classes are basically used to model real world entities inside of our program. So I'm gonna show you guys how we can build a class in order to do that. The first step when we want to build a class is you want to open up your Solution Explorer over here. In my case, it's just over here on the right side of my screen. And I'm going to go down to my project. So I'm over here in my draft project. And when I want to create a new class, I can just right click and I'm going to go down to Add. And I'm just going to click New Item. And then over here, we should get this little menu that pops up and it says Class. This is the first one right up here. So I'm going to select that. And then I can actually come down here to the bottom and give this a name. So I'm going to go ahead and name my class. And generally, when we're creating a class in C#, you want to name it with a capital letter. So in this situation, I think we should create a class for a book. So let's say that I was writing a program. Maybe this was a program for like a library or a school bookstore. And I wanted to be able to represent a book inside of my program. So I want to create a book data type. So just like I create a string or I create an integer or I create a Boolean, I want to be able to create an actual book inside of my program. So I'm going to create a book class and I'm just going to call this book.cs and I'll hit enter. And you guys will see over here that another file has been added to our Solution Explorer. So now we have this book.cs file. And you'll notice that this is pretty much laid out exactly like the other one. So exactly like this program class that we were using over here. And it's basically just like an empty class. So remember what I said, a class is essentially just a specification for, or really it's like a blueprint for a new data type in our program. And one of the cool things about C# is it actually allows us to, you know, specify a custom data type. And essentially what we want to do is we're going to be creating a complex data type. So a string, for example, is a data type, right? And all it is just plain text. A number is a data type, and all it is just, you know, a number, right? We have integers, we have floats, they're whole numbers and decimal numbers. But when we create this book data type, it's actually gonna be composed of all of those other data types. So inside of here, we're gonna define a series of attributes. And these attributes are basically going to describe what a book is inside of our program. And that's generally what you wanna do when you create a class. You're gonna take a class, and you're going to give it a series of attributes. And like I said, those attributes will kind of define what it is. So I have this book class, and I want to think about what are the different attributes that are going to allow me to represent a book inside of my program. And what I want to do is I want to actually create variables for each of those. So let's think about this. What are the different attributes of a book? Well, I can think of the first one is going to be title. So over here, I'm going to say string title. And before I say string title, I'm going to say public. So I want to say public string title. And I'm actually going to make this lowercase. So that's one attribute that we could store about a book. What's another one? Well, let's think. We would also want to store the book's author. So I can say public string author. And let's just try to think of one more. So I think one more good one might be the number of pages. So I'm going to say public int pages. And all of these different variables that we're declaring over here are called class attributes. And these are essentially pieces of information that are describing what a book is in our program. So I'm essentially modeling the book data type. I'm creating a blueprint for the book data type. I'm saying that inside of our program, a book is going to have a title, an author, and a number of pages. So this is a specification, it's a template. Now what I can do is I can go off to my other program and I can actually create a book inside of my program. So just like I create a string or I create an integer or I create a double or a boolean, I can create a book and I can store it inside of a variable and we can actually create something called an object, which is gonna be a actual book inside of our program. So I'm gonna show you guys how we can do that. I'm gonna save this file. And I'm going to head back over to program.cs. So this is like the file that has our main method over here. And I want to show you guys how we can create a book now. So if I wanted to create and represent an actual book inside of my program, since I created that class and I defined what a book is, I basically defined the book data type, I can actually do that. And I can create something called an object. And an object is an instance of a class. So when we created the class, we created the template for what a book is. When we create an object, we're creating an actual physical book inside of our program, right? So over here, this class specified like a title, author, pages, right? This is a specification for what a book is. When I create a book object, I'm creating an actual book with an actual title, actual number of pages, and an actual author. So I'm gonna show you guys how we can do that. The first thing I want to do is I'm basically going to create this like I would a normal variable. So the first thing I'll do is specify the data type. And in our case, we're going to create a book using the book data type. So just like if I was creating a string, I would say like string, you know, whatever is equal to whatever. Here, I'm just going to say book and we're going to do the same thing. So I'm going to say book, I'm going to give this a name. So why don't we just call it book one. And now what I'm going to do is set it equal to new book and an open and close parentheses. And this is how we can create what's called a book object. This is essentially an instance of a book. So this is like a physical book inside of our program. So the class is a specification. The class tells us what the book data type is. An object is an actual instance of that class. All right, so hopefully that makes sense. So now I've actually created this book called book one. And we can use book one over here just like a variable. I mean, it's essentially just a variable that's storing a book object. So remember, the book has all of these attributes, right? So a book can have a title, a book can have an author, and a book can have a number of pages. So when we create our book, we want to give it all of those attributes. So what I can do is I can say like book one dot, and now I can access the attribute. So I could say book one dot title, and I can actually give this a value. So let's say that we wanted to create an object that would represent one of the Harry Potter books. So I could say book1.title is equal to Harry Potter. So now the title of my book is going to be Harry Potter. Let's come down here and we'll say book1.author, and the author of the Harry Potter books is J.K. Rowling. So I'm going to say book1.author is equal to J.K. Rowling. And then finally down here, we're going to say book1.pages. And let's just say that this Harry Potter book has 400 pages in it. So what I did was I created a book object, which is an instance of the book class. And I was able to define all of the pieces of information about this book. So I defined what the book's title was. I defined what the book's author was. And I defined how many pages the book had. And so now what I can actually do is I can work with this piece of information. So I could say like console.writeLine, and over here I could print out some attributes of the book. So I could say like book1.title. And now when I run my program, it's gonna print out the title of the book we just created. So it should print out Harry Potter. I could do the same thing for the other attributes. So I could say like book1.pages. And now we're gonna print out however many pages book one has. So we're gonna get 400. So essentially I'm creating here a book, right? I defined the book data type in that class, and now I'm creating an actual book inside of my class, which we're calling an object. And what's cool about these objects is I can create as many objects as I wanted. So I could come down here and I could actually make another object. So I'm gonna copy this guy and I'm actually gonna paste it down here. And instead of being book one, I'm gonna change it to book two. So this is gonna be book two, book two, book two, book two. So let's start giving this some different information. Let's say this object is gonna represent one of the Lord of the Rings books. So I could say Lord of the Rings, and then the author is Tolkien. And let's say the Lord of the Rings has like, I don't know, 700 pages in it. So now I have a book up here called book one, which is representing the Harry Potter book. And then I have another book down here, book two, which is representing the Lord of the Rings book. And I'm actually able to have an actual book in my program, right? So I'm able to represent and store and work with and model a book inside of my program. So down here, I could do the same with book two. I could say like book two dot author. And now this is gonna print out the author of book two. So you'll see over here, we get Tolkien. Now, I wanna bring up one point. So both of these objects are books, right? Over here in this book class, I defined the book data type. I basically told C#, like, hey, we got a new data type. It's a book, it's awesome. All books have a title, an author, and a number of pages. And over here, I created individual books off of that blueprint, off of that template, right? So book one is its own book. It has its own title, its own author, and its own pages. Book two down here is another book, and it has its own title, its own author, and its own pages. So if I was creating an application for like a library, for example, let's say the library had 10,000 books. Well, I could create 10,000 objects, all of which would have the title, the author, and the number of pages of each one of those books. And then I could work with those books. I could pass them into methods. I could use them in if statements. I could do all sorts of stuff with those books, just like I would with other data types like strings, numbers, or Booleans. So classes and objects are extremely powerful. And really, this is just scratching the surface. This is like lesson one. You know, this is the bare basics of working with classes and objects. As we go forward for the next few videos, we're gonna learn all sorts of ways to make these a lot more powerful. Hey, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and subscribe to Draft Academy to be the first to know when we release new content. Also, we're always looking to improve, so if you have any constructive criticism or questions or anything, leave a comment below. Finally, if you're enjoying Draft Academy and you wanna help us grow, head over to draftacademy.com/contribute and invest in our future.